Hello friends, myself Amar. Now in this video I will discuss how to use Ajax with select one menu in Prime Faces. Okay, here what I have done, I have created a project Ajax dropdown and it has a index.html page. Now in the Ripple's code package I have created a managed bin named as mobile bin. Okay, now in the index.html page what I have done, I have used a form and I have used a growl having the ID as msgs, and in the so detail attribute I have written true. Then after that I have used the panel having the header as select a mobile brand, then I have used the style. Okay, after that I have used the panel grid having the number of column as 2 and cell padding as 5. Then I have used the output label, and in the output label I have used for equals to brand, and the value I have specified as mobile brand. Okay, after that I have used select one menu having the ID as brand, and in the value I have written mb.brand. This means whatever value we will select from this select one menu will be assigned to the brand property of the managed bin. Okay, after that I have used Ajax, and in the listener I have written mb.onBrandChange, and in the update attribute I have written model. This means whenever we will select item from this select one menu, at that time this on brand change method of the managed bin will be called and it will update the model. Okay, what is this model? This model is nothing but the ID of another select one menu which I have created here. Okay, after that inside this select one menu I have used select item having the item label as select brand. Okay, and after that again I have used the select items, and in the value I have written mb.allbrands. This means the all brands property of the managed bin will be called, and the values which has been assigned to this all brands will be the items of this select one menu. Okay, and as I told you, whenever items will be selected from this select one menu, then this Ajax will be fired. It will call the on brand change of the managed bin, and it will update the model which is nothing but the ID of this select one menu. Okay, now here what I have done, I have created the output label having the value as model, and inside this select one menu I have given the ID as model, and in the value I have written mb.model. This means the value which we will select from this select one menu will be assigned to the model property of the managed bin, and in the select item I have written item label as select model, item value blank, and here I have written f select item, and the value I have written mb.allModels. All models means the value which has been assigned to the all models property of the managed bin will be the items inside the select one menu. Okay, after that I have used a separator, I have created a command button, and whenever this button will be clicked, it will update msgs, which is nothing but the ID of this growl, and whenever this button will be clicked, then it will fire the display model method of the managed bin. This is the entire code of the index.xhtml. okay, now let me move to the mobile bin. Here the name of the managed bin I have given as mb. Here I have used the view scoped. This means it will be, the scope will be to view. Okay, after that I have created a mobile bin, managed bin. Now inside this I have created a map having the key as a string and the value as the map of string and string. I have given the name as data. After that I have created few more properties named as brand, model, all brands, all models. Okay, and after that I have created the getter and setter of these properties, right? As you can see, the getter and setter of these properties has been created. Okay, these are the getter and setters. Now inside the post construct, inside the init method, what I have done, I have created the object of the all brands, and in the all brands what I have done, I have used the put method, and I have written Samsung, that is the key, and Samsung, that is nothing but the value. Similarly I have added Oppo and Sony. Okay, after that I have created the object of map, and here I have used the put method, and here I have added three values of Samsung. Okay, after adding these values to the map, what I am doing, I am adding this map to this data. Now if you remember, this data is nothing but the map having the key as a string and the value as map. Okay, that's why here I have written data.put. This is the key and this is nothing but the map. This means inside this Samsung all these values will be added. Similarly, I have created the same thing for Oppo, as you can see this, and similarly I have created the same thing for Sony. Okay, now after that I have used the on brand change method. Here I have written the code. If brand is not equals to null and if brand is not equals to empty, then what will happen, all the brands will be added to the all models. Okay, else all models will be equals to this. After that I have created the display model method. Here also I have checked, if model is not equals to null and brand is not equals to null, then what will happen, it will generate the faces message having the value as selected, after that model name, brand name. Otherwise it will display invalid, model is not selected. This means if the model is not selected and if someone clicks on the button, then this message will be displayed. Okay, and this is the entire code of the managed bin. Just have a look, this is the entire code of the managed bin, right? Now let me show you the output. Once I go to the browser, then you can see select a mobile brand. Here we need to choose the mobile brand. Suppose I am choosing the mobile brand as Sony. Now without choosing the model, if I click here, then it is displaying invalid, model is not selected, the message which has been written here. Okay, but if I select the model and after that if I click on the button, then it will display the model which we have selected of which brand, that is Sony Xperia XZ of Sony brand. Okay, this is how we can use the Ajax with the drop down. Means the value, whenever the value we are selecting from the brand, then the Ajax event is fired. It is loading the model in this drop down as I have written in this code. As you can see, whenever the value is selected from this brand drop down, then this Ajax is fired, which is calling the on brand change method, and it is updating the model. This means whenever the value we are selecting from this brand, based on the brand, it is populating the model by using Ajax. Okay, that's it. And this is the entire code of the index.xhtml page, as you can see, right? And this is the code for the managed bin, right? This is the code for the managed bin, right? I hope you have liked my video. If you have liked my video, please subscribe to my channel. Thank you so much.